I am LaMarcia Lewis. Let's talk. Today is Tuesday, December the 8th, 2020. Today's conversation is going to be talking about what we seem to, or what I seem to talk about in probably many or most of my videos, which is Trump. And that is because I try to keep up with what is going on. This platform is about sharing information, having conversation, and most of all, just what's currently going on inside our world, our country of the United States. And that so happens to be that, like news media and outlets and social media outlets, the conversation is about the current president, which happens to be Donald J. Trump. We are 43 days away from the new administration will take place January the 20th, 2021, the Biden-Harris administration. And in the meantime, we're still talking about Trump because it's every day he continues to do something that is newsworthy, and some things need to be made known to us, the American people, the public. Then some things should not be tolerated, and that is his still alleging accusation of a rigged election, still spewing lies that he won in various states where he did not, just like this past Saturday, December the 5th, when he had went to a rally in support of the two Georgia Republican senators that are seeking re-election. That happens to be Kelly Loeffler and David Perdue. There was a rally in Georgia where Trump and his wife Melania, who spoke and gave her introduction of her husband. And of course, Trump was spotting the lies. Kelly and David pacifying the adult male, stating that we need Georgia to win. We need to keep our seats. And Kelly, Mr. President, you made America great again. David, I want to make a personal statement to the president. Mr. President, all that. So we will have some conversations about Trump. Want to talk about Pfizer, who is developing a vaccine that hopefully will soon be available. Talk about the press secretary, Kayleigh McEnany, and just various other conversation that we will have. First of all, today it was stated that Pfizer had offered the Trump administration a vaccine this past summer, or early distribution or a count that they could have on hand that could be have offered to the American citizens, but it was stated that the Trump administration denied these vaccines. And as today, it was said that the Trump administration are saying that this is not true. They deny the claim at all that there was a vaccine that they could have gotten and that they rejected it. It stated that the Trump administration denies or dismisses what Pfizer said that they offered them vaccine. Kayleigh McEnany, the press secretary, she was on Fox News this past weekend, and that has been trending on social media, Twitter. You can always Google and get the newest video clips of whatever is going on. And I'm gonna play this clip. It's not that long, so I just want you all to hear what the press secretary, it's an 18 second clip, but she suggests a special legislation session to be called. In fact, it was stated that Trump on Saturday actually called the governor of Georgia trying to get him to have a special election, call their legislators back so that they can have a special legislative session to overturn the votes, the will of the people, because he still wants to get the electoral votes to be the winner in the state of Georgia. But this is what Kelly had to say on Fox and Friends, and I'm sharing this from a social media where our Twitter follower that I follow on Twitter, the recount, and it says, dead ender Kayleigh McEnany yells at Georgia Governor Kemp on Fox News, you have the power to call in special legislature session, because right now, if we lose these two Senate seats, guess who's casting the deciding vote for our country, our government? it would be Kamala Harris. So I'm going to play, it's an 18 second clip.
Call in a special legislative session, because right now, if we lose these two Senate seats, guess who's casting the deciding...
Let me start that over.
Kamala Harris. Kemp, you have the power to call in a special legislative session, because right now, if we lose these two Senate seats, guess who's casting the deciding vote in this country for our government? It will be Kamala Harris. Call for the special legislative session. Governor Kemp can also threaten the budget of the Secretary of State. There is plenty he can do. Kemp, you have the power to call in a special legislative session, because right now, if we lose these two Senate seats, guess who's casting the deciding vote in this country for our government? It will be Kamala Harris. Call for the special legislative session. Governor Kemp can also threaten the budget of the Secretary of State. There is plenty he can do. Kemp.
I was like, did she really use the term there that he can threaten the budget? Actually saying that they can use their power to whatever the advancement needs to be so they can get done what they want to be done, which is to have the votes overturned, just basically insulting the people of Georgia, the will of the people, because Trump is trying to have his way, because he, in all honesty, needs to remain in that White House so he won't have to basically be subjected to what awaits him. Attorney General for New York, Letitia James, was on The View today, and she was saying that there is an investigation that is going on right now. As she stated, it's a civil case, but depends on what the investigation determines and what type of results that they get in the information. Of course, that civil case may can turn into a criminal case where there would be a higher charge and thicker, stronger penalties that may apply. So right now she did state that it is a civil case, but they are investigating, and it depends on what that investigation results determine as to what will take place. But she stated that Trump is not above the law. No one is above the law. But again, Kayleigh McEnany was saying that actually, the governor can also threaten the budget of the Secretary of State. There is plenty he can do. And the pure fact that they are out here trying to overturn the election result that the American people voted, that's what an election is about. We, the American people, we go to polls, we vote. We cast our votes. We make our voices heard, and we make that choice of what candidate that we feel is best for us, best for our country. And the mere suggestion that Trump is doing and has been doing, and this is still going on, has not been called out, is still, even today I saw where the GOP rejected calling President-elect Biden, trying to stop the inauguration process, the GOP. This is just absurd. This has never happened before. So I don't get it. I don't understand it. I don't think I ever will. Trump called the Speaker of the Pennsylvania House of Representatives twice during the past week to request help reversing the loss in the state of Pennsylvania. Again, he's continuing to make all desperation attempts to sway, overturn the will of the people. This is not right. This is the third state Trump has directly attempted to overturn the results. Governor of Georgia said that there will not be a special legislature. He will not call a special legislature. Trump lost the state of Georgia, and the electoral votes did go to President-elect Joe Biden. So I was happy to hear that Governor Kemp is not going to call a special election. He's not complying to Trump's threat or to the press secretary's threat to have special legislation. Or, as she said, there's a lot that governors can do, can threaten the budget, which may basically mean holding funds. And we know Trump has did this several times during his presidency, holding funds. The government has been shut down for various petty things by Trump. You have Republicans saying they're disgusted. It's not right. It's not fair. It's gone too far. But yet and still, no one is really calling out Trump or holding him accountable. Last week, implementation manager Gabriel Sterling went viral with his video when he was vividly upset. And again, like I said, I understood why he was upset. I think he had cause to be. He called out one of their two senators that are seeking re-election to call this out, but yet they did not. Like I said, they had a Trump rally where they was praising Trump, but you got the Lieutenant Governor Jeff Duncan saying it's disgusting, it's not who we are, it's not Americans. But if it's not who we are and if it's not American way, who the Constitution and what we represent, our democracy, then why is it being allowed? Why is Trump with these false allegations? And they know that they are false allegations. All on Twitter, whenever he tweets, there's a message out there. This is a false, not accurate statement. But he's still trying to go to court. He's still saying they won when there were states that he didn't win, but he's claiming. My question is, where are the adults? Where are the adults? Are there any in the room? I know earlier in his presidency, when the op-ed came through and it was stated that it was like a whistleblower and there are adults in the room. Well, where are the adults? Where are the adults in the room? Because the current adults, the GOP, Mitch McConnell, Lindsey Graham going out his way, and out of 249 Republicans, it's been said that only 20 of them or 27 of them has acknowledged that Joe Biden will be the next president. All of the rest are sitting silent and complicit. Every now and then you hear something that supposedly Mitt Romney said, but he's still not calling out Trump. He's not holding Trump accountable. Mitch McConnell know that Trump would not be president on January the 20th. He would not have a second term. So does, I mean, all of them, we know it. The American people know it. So you know all the public officials know it. Other countries have welcomed and gave congratulations to President-elect. Here we are, our own are being very immature. Trump has never operated or presented the office of the president or being president with dignity. Never. He has only operated in his own ego and corruption and giving tax breaks to the millionaires and billionaires, the rich, not us, the average struggling, just want to trying to make it American people. It's appalling that the GOP are not holding him, or they're not being accountable for the lack of leadership. Where is real, true leadership? It will take place January the 20th, 2021, 12 o'clock noon, when Joe Biden and Kamala Harris are sworn in as the next president and vice president of the United States. Trump has made false accusations and claims ever since AP, which is the Associated Press, announced on November the 7th that Joe Biden was the presidential person that won the presidential election for 2020. He has done nothing but make false accusations and claims. The Republican Senate has done nothing to stop this. They have not denounced it. These absurd and outrageous false claims and outright lies. Trump lost the election. We need real adults, real accountable men and women to be just that, accountable and let it be known that Trump only had one term. And let's not forget, he was also impeached. In my opinion, if he was impeached and this was his first term as the president, he shouldn't even have been allowed to run for a second term. Again, that is my opinion. I think there needs to be an amendment to our Constitution that if a president is in the first term of his presidency or her, one day we just may have a woman, but if something takes place in the first term and they actually get impeached in the House of Representatives, but yet the Senate do not remove them, he or she should not be able to run for a second term because you actually are an impeached president. Today's media topic is being reported Trump still calling and summoning people to the White House in an effort, a desperation to overturn election results, the will of the people. When would this be considered a criminal act? That the sitting president of the United States is trying to overturn the will of the people, and you have a GOP Senate that's sitting back complicit and silent and not doing anything about this. I feel like that should be investigated. When would this stop? Will it stop? That it will stop. Even if he continues these at January 20, 2021, a new presidential administration would take place. But it's sad that we are having to endure these treacherous times. This should not be happening in our country. It isn't who we are supposed to represent. What has happened? When did common decency really just go out the door, out the window? That no one wants to be held accountable. No one wants to stand up and take accountability. No one wants to have values, morals, ethics. No one is standing up for right and denouncing wrong. I was brought up to treat people the way you want to be treated, to do what is right, to be kind, to always tell the truth, help somebody else. Don't lie, be honest, be a good person. And I believe these values. I know everyone wasn't taught values of this, but I believe in values of being good and kind, doing the right thing, even if you're the only one to do the right thing. GOP leadership rejects resolution, acknowledging that Biden has won the president. That's just absurd. It was said that the representative, Jim Jordan, which is a Trump supporter, has been encouraging Trump to continue not to concede to the election results. Said he was asked, well, should Monday, which would be December the 14th, where all the electors is to be casted, should Trump then Monday concede? It was stated that Jordan said, no, no way, no way, no way. Just makes no sense. A total of 249 Republicans and only 27 have actually acknowledged or congratulated the new president-elect Joe Biden. And again, president, or if I say vice president, and or former Senator Biden, he's not new to the political realm. He started as a representative at the age of 29. He have been in politics over many decades. He has ran 3 times for the presidency. And as they say, third time's a charm. So many of these men and women have worked with Mr. Biden, President-elect Joe Biden. They know him. They know the man he is. They know the character he is. They know the leadership that he exemplifies. and to just be so disrespectful is just, it's appalling. It's hurtful. It's shameful. It's sad. It's simply I can't fathom it, because it just doesn't make sense that grown adults, men and women that are public officials serving in our United States Congress, representatives, senators, are rejecting the results from we, the people of these United States. All because they are sitting complicit and silent to they were rejected, or that Trump was rejected, because Trump refuse to accept, because they know when we got the results on November the 7th, that was the results. Trump lost, Biden won. It's absurd. It's truly just, and this is what seems to be daily, day in, day out conversation. Trump's reaching, trying to overturn the will of the people. And the Republic Senate and Congress, governors, because as I stated, he reached out to Governor Brian Kemp, and I saw Lieutenant Governor of Georgia, Jeff Duncan, did an interview with Jake Trapper on CNN, calling it, as I stated, disgusting, but yet he acknowledged that he voted for Trump. He supports Trump. But his concern is they have those two Republican senators that are seeking re-election, so he's concerned to Trump's message of a rigged election, because that could hurt and damage the Republican senators Kelly Loeffler and David Perdue getting reelected. That's his concern, but he's not concerned that Trump is actually doing these outrageous things, calling a rigged election when there was no rigged election. It's just that he wasn't the person that was selected, or he didn't get enough votes to win. It's disgusting, but you're not calling him out. You're concerned that his messaging is going to keep you all or your Republican senators from having their seats, in which I hope they don't get reelected. I hope Georgia flips their state blue for the Senate race as they did for the presidential election. That election would take place January the 5th, so less than a month. Georgia, yesterday, Monday, December the 7th, was the last day for voter registration so that they could vote in the upcoming Senate race. I hope many in all Georgia, if you weren't already registered, I hope you did. But most importantly, I hope you will go out in record numbers as you did for the presidential election, because we need you. We need to have Democratic senators in the White House, in the Senate, in Washington, D.C., to help represent us and to hopefully help regain dignity, trust, truthfulness, fairness, honesty, regain the soul of our country. The message of President-elect Joe Biden's campaign, to regain the soul of our country, where respect most of all, even if you disagree. The Bible tells us to do all things in decency and in order. We're not going to always agree. We're not going to always get along. That's what makes each person the unique individual he or she is. Whether that's twins that are identical, that look alike, but they still their own unique individual self. So it's not about always agreeing and getting along, but it is about doing what is right, being respectful, not being corrupt, not being a bully, not going on Twitter and rages and belittle or dragging people, disrespecting people because something didn't go your way and you're an adult. are trying to suppress people, being a racist, only caring about your own and not everyone. President-elect Biden said he would be the American president for all people, not just Democratic people or just the people that voted, but every American, every person of the United States. Well, Trump only concern is his base. If you like him, he loves you. If you don't like him, he doesn't care anything. In fact, to him, you don't exist. So I just feel like it's time to come together. I know we can. In time, we will. I am a person of faith, a real person. I know many people will say, well, I'm a Christian. Just because you say it, don't make it so. It's your actions that proves who you are. And that's in any and everything. Locally and on a big level where you have power as well. So this is today's conversation with I Am LaMarcia Lewis, Let's Talk YouTube channel. I hope you have enjoyed this conversation. As always, please feel free to leave me comments in the comment section. We can always have a conversation there. I welcome any and all positive feedback. If there is a conversation that you would like to have me talk about and discuss, let me know. Reach out to me. Put it in the comment section or check out my email. It's in my bio and all of that. I'm just trying to build this platform. And as I say all the time, I can only do that with your help and your support. I am grateful for any and all support and encouragement. It means so much, more than you will ever know. Trusting God for this platform to build, and it will take me to a actual career that I will be so grateful for, so humble, because I will not forget where I come from in humble beginnings, because I know God can elevate you and can also bring you back to reality. So it's my goal to grow this platform, to get a platform that would be bigger than just YouTube. One day, like I say, TV talk show host, a commentator, political analyst, work in politics, however God's what his ultimate will is for me. I know greater is coming. Greater is coming. So please subscribe, please like, please share. If you feel comfortable, leave comments. Until we talk the next time, I am LaMarcia Lewis. Let's talk.